Hey, what's good, guys? This is Chris from WearTesters.com. Welcome back to the official WearTesters.com YouTube channel. Today, we are taking a look at these guys right here. This is the Air Jordan 4 Flyknit, the all-red version, which is pretty obvious. So let's take a look, shall we? Real quick, just wanted to showcase that the box lid is a little bit different. The box itself is not anything crazy. It's kind of got that old Jordan finish to it. I don't know if they're going to be keeping these style boxes for, you know, the rest of like new models or whatever, because they keep changing things. Like we got retro boxes, we got that black matte finish box with a gold logo on top, and now we got this one with the flight logo. So I don't know what the deal is, but these come in that box, just for anybody wondering. So if you're buying them aftermarket or whatever it is, make sure they come in that box. Now the Flyknit 4 is interesting. This is not the first Flyknit Jordan that we've seen. We've seen them introduce Flyknit to the Jordans. First off in, well, technically it was in that, it was performance woven, but that's like still Flyknit. I mean, if we want to be like real technical, the knit thing was introduced with the Air Jordan 29. And then we saw it in the Air Jordan 29 and Air Jordan 1 pack, where the 1 got kind of flipped with the 29. The 1 was woven, the 29 was leather. The first official Flyknit version of the Air Jordan, though, came in the form of the Air Jordan 1. And then shortly after, we saw the Air Jordan 3 release only in one colorway. What gifts? But the Flyknit 4, they're coming out in 4 colorways, and wow, because they're all like really bright colors. Now, first things first, the outsole right here is translucent. It's kind of got a weird look to it because it looks like they literally painted some solid rubber sections. Like this midfoot and the heel looks like some customizer painted it. I don't know what's up with that. Honestly, I don't really like it. The forefoot does look pretty cool though. And the outsole of the Air Jordan 4 just looks awesome. So you got to give it credit for that. The midsole though, the midsole is interesting because it's way softer than some of the polyurethane that we've seen on, you know, previous retros, especially if we're counting like the brand new ones from this year, like the black and red or black and cement, the breads, if you will. And what was that other colorway called? The one that we did? Flight Nostalgia?
Yes.
But also a bunch of other names?
Crimson.
Bright Crimson, Laser, lots of names. Lots of names. So the midsole right here, I believe it's still polyurethane. It just feels different. It feels a little bit lighter. It feels a little bit softer, all that kind of stuff. So if you're into comfort, these are going to be one of those shoes that's going to give that to you while still giving you that kind of retro feel. The tech specs are still the same though. We have the visible air unit, 4 foot air unit, but you can't see it. It's encapsulated in there. The insole itself is leather lined, which is again, like this is supposed to be kind of like a premium style release. And the insole itself is a super thick ortholite. Like this thing's crazy. It's got a lot of step and comfort in these guys. Now the materials are all Flyknit, but not all Flyknit is treated the same. So this guy right here has got a couple different variations. Behind the Flyknit, it is actually nylon. So they're not like the Air Jordan 1 Flyknit. I don't have the Air Jordan 3, so I can't compare them to those. But this Flyknit is just a little bit stiffer. The Air Jordan 1's version of the Flyknit shoe was very like sock-like. It just kind of felt like a Flyknit runner made into an actual Air Jordan. Whereas these guys feel like they're almost performance driven, even though I know that they're not. So this whole rand right here feels like a TPU coated knit. So it's got that crispy feel to it. I'm not a big fan of that, but it gives it some shape, it gives it some structure, gives it that look right there of the Air Jordan 4 paneling. And that portion of the knit actually really reminds me of the Nike Kobe AD NXT 360, where it has that kind of fishing line feeling onto it. That's kind of what this is. It's not what I was expecting. It's not bad, it's just not good to me. Depends on what you want. If you like this kind of stuff, then it's cool. I just was expecting a little bit different because they were able to weave or knit into the build of the Jordan 1 Flyknit. The actual look of the Air Jordan 1, the paneling and all that stuff, which I thought was awesome. And they did that here too. They just kind of took it a step further with the, I don't know what you would call it. It's just plasticky feeling. Like it feels like they heat pressed it, and I'm just surprised. The rest of the knit though feels kind of good. It's very thick, especially in the side panel area where we typically see the mesh window and all that stuff, which is very interesting. I did think that they would be a little bit more breathable than they are, but you know, it is what it is. It definitely gives you that Jordan 4 feel. I don't really know what I was expecting at this point. Like I've seen these for a while now. It's just in hand. I thought they would be a little bit softer than what they are. The tongue itself though, very nice. It's got that softer feel that you would expect from typical Flyknit shoes. And then we have the patch right there, but it's done up in rubber, so it's not that, you know, little sewn on embroidered patch and stuff like that. It's kind of got a different feel to it, which is interesting. And then inside of the patch, it has what you would typically see inside of an Air Jordan 4 with the upside down patch logo, but it's lined in leather. Kind of got a weird finish to it though. It's kind of a unfinished around the edges, while the lining itself, just like the insole, is also in leather. All the typical accents you'd see on the Air Jordan 4 are done in that same rubbery feel that the patch on the tongue is, including the little wings right there and the heel tab on the back. And then behind that, it actually says established in 1989. As far as fit is concerned, I went down half a size. I feel that that's the best move. That's what I did in the Air Jordan 1 Flyknit as well. Again, I don't have the Air Jordan 3 Flyknit, so I really don't know, you know, what those fit like or feel like or anything like that. I do know that I really liked the way that that shoe looked. It's probably my favorite looking of the Flyknit Jordan so far. I just wish that they released in more colors, because the black with that greenish bottom, I wasn't feeling. I was hoping we'd see something maybe a little bit more traditional like we did with the Air Jordan 1s, but that didn't happen. I was also hoping to see something like that with these guys, but again, that doesn't look like it's happening. We already got the original Jordan 4 re-release earlier this year, along with a bunch of different new colorways for both men, women's, and children. Now, the retail price is pretty high. It's gonna be $220, very expensive, I think. However, they are gonna be available locally here in Sacramento. So if you are here in the area, make sure to check out Phenom. All of their information is gonna be down below in the description box. They take phone orders. They also open late. So if you're not in the area and you're trying to do a phone order, they don't open till 1 p.m. our time. Those are like great hours. I got it, like, you get to sleep in for days. You know what I mean? But thank you so much for watching. Thanks for all your support. Let me know what you guys think about these. Are you a fan of the Air Jordan 4 Flyknit? I do like the blue colorway the best. Nightwing flavors, I know. The red colorway, maybe the second one in the line. I don't know about the other two. The Volt one, a little bright for me, although I like the Volt Air Maxes. Yeah, maybe it's because it's the Jordan. And then I didn't not like the orange one. I just wouldn't wear them. You know what I mean? You know how you're kind of like indifferent to some things? I'm kind of indifferent to those. But sound off below and let us know what you think about these. Do you think that the Air Jordan 4 done up in Flyknit looks good? You think it should have been done? And are you happy with the colorways? Or what would you do? Like, if you were in charge of this model right here, what would you have done? Thank you so much for watching once again. And until next time, guys, have a good one. So what do you think about Flyknit Jordans? Because you've seen the ones, right?
Yes.
Okay, did you like those?
Well, my memory of them is hazy because you completely threw me when you started pointing out all of, I haven't gotten a chance to like hold these really and look at them. Mm-hmm. But you threw me when you were pulling out and showing all the leather pieces. I thought this was a shoe that would be great for vegans and all that stuff, like the Kobe 4s and all that.
You know, looking at the back of it, that's not real leather.
Oh.
It's a synthetic, the coating.
Yeah.
Like that they would spray on actual leather to give it, because there's no red cows, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, well, there might be, but I mean, not in our area. So they do that, and then it mimics that leather look, but behind there, that's where you'd be able to see like what the grain is, like how thick the cut is and all that stuff. And there isn't any back there. It's just whatever that coating would be.
Yeah.
And then some kind of like material to keep it together and stuff.
They need to start utilizing those stickers then though, because that would be a great selling point, I feel, with these.
That's what I'm saying though, is that it's not even a selling point to vegans, just like for regular people, like they would see this on shelf and they'd be like, oh, it's leather lined, but it's like, yeah, it doesn't even smell like leather. Like, it's not leather.
It kind of smells like your guys' action figures.
Like plasticky?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and so that's what I'm saying though, is like it's confusing for people because the touch and the look looks like, you know what I'm saying? And so like, you do have to, well, they don't have to actually, like they don't, like these brands don't have to teach consumers what their product is and what it's about, you know what I mean? But they should.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess that's where, you know, a review comes in, I guess. But this is a shoe that I honestly wasn't even interested in because I wouldn't wear this.
I like these.
I like them in hand, but it's so much red, you know? Like I was telling her last night, that I feel like I should paint the midsole kind of like that fire red look with the black top line and then the white middle, just to break up the red, because it's so just, you know, and I don't wear stuff like this. I like the old school color blocking and stuff. Like I like those things that highlight, you know, the shoe and the panels and stuff. That's why I like the Jordan 1 Flyknit so much, because they definitely had that OG feel and they played up on OG colors. They mm-hmm. gave you new colors as well. So it was really cool to see truly something old turned into something new. But this is not that. This is like a reimagining. It's almost jarring.
They just look, so I have the Flight Nostalgia 4s, and
you would like wearing these.
These look way more comfortable.
Yeah, like wide footers.
Yeah.
Cause like I said, I had to go down half a size in these because the Flyknit Jordans don't have all the padding and stuff, you know what I mean? So like they're kind of like naked inside, and so they will fit a little bit bigger. So going down half a size for me worked out. If you're a wide footer, you still might be able to go down half a size, but you shouldn't have that pinky toe.
My poor pinky toe. Like so. I wear them and they're fine at first, but as the day goes on and my foot is like, please get me out of here. These look like...
Yeah, this would be much better for like over like the course of a day when your foot starts to swell and stuff like that. Like it would be more comfortable, more form-fitting, more forgiving than something like that.
So this midsole, it's like my one slip-ons, yeah?
That I don't know. I was trying to ask. Like, let me see if he responded yet. I was asking somebody at the brand. Yeah, he hasn't gotten back to me yet. So he's not the one that, he's in charge of performance. I think this is labeled Jordan Sportswear. You know, they're not the same space or whatever. So like he didn't work on it. So he doesn't know what the specs were, but it just feels spongier. Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel like the polyurethane that they use now on a lot of the retros, it's so that they don't crack, because polyurethane back in the day was very comfortable, or at least like considering like cup soles, which are solid rubber. So like back in the day, like when they switched from cup soles to polyurethane midsoles, they were at the time the top of the line type of tech. Nowadays, obviously we have EVAs and different renditions of that. So it's a lot more forgiving than polyurethane, but polyurethane is very much open cell foam. So over time it deteriorates. It takes in a lot of moisture and all that stuff, and it'll literally crumble. So the new stuff of polyurethane they make to last, because people were complaining that shoes were crumbling after 10 years.
Yeah.
So this stuff though feels different, and I don't know if it's Phylon, because it doesn't feel the same. It feels a little bit denser than typical Phylon, even for Nike standards, and it feels heavier as well. So I don't think it's that, but at the same time, it definitely doesn't feel like that retro polyurethane that we've been getting, where it's kind of brick-like. He did tell me that when I asked like what is it, like he was saying that there are new polyurethane blends.
Okay.
So there's that. I just don't know if they've used it or what that even means, really. Like, I didn't like ask them to go into detail, but
they might be knitted, but they ain't your grandma's Jordans.
What compels you to do these corny things?
It's just natural.